They're asking us to plug in negative 2 for x. So if we do that, looks like this. And so to figure this out without converting it to a decimal, that negative 2 needs that negative 2 can become an exponent on top of both of these. Okay, so when you have a power on the outside, when it's all just one term like this, then the power can come apply to both numbers in the fraction like that. And so this is 1. 1 to any power is still 1. So that one's nice and simple. And then here, this is 3 to the negative second. But we don't like negative exponents in our final answer. So one thing we can do is we can always change the sign of the exponent by moving it from downstairs to upstairs or vice versa. So 1 over 3 to the negative second, that's the same thing as 3 to the second, because I moved the 3 upstairs and it's like there's a 1 still left over downstairs, so you can just drop it. So that's 3 to the second, which is 9. Okay, this next one, we're plugging in negative 1. So same thing, make that power apply to both numbers in the fraction. So 1 to the negative first power is 1, 3 to the negative first, we'll keep it right there, and then we want it to be a positive exponent, so move that upstairs. So that becomes 3 to the first, but 3 to the first is 3, and 3 divided by 1 is 3, so that's our answer there. Anything to the 0 power is 1, regardless if it's a fraction or not. And then if you plug in 1, that's just 1/3. And if you plug in 2, then you can square the top and square the bottom. 1 squared is 1, and then 3 squared is 9, so 1/9 would be here.